Hi there, I'm Pierrick, a Google Ads API developer advocate. Welcome to the Optimization Score and Recommendation series. In this particular episode, we do a deep dive into the technical aspects of Optimization Score. For a complete list of the resources and previous episodes, please check the video description. I will do some coding that requires a basic knowledge of Google Ads API reporting and the Google Ads query language, or GACL for short. Feel free to check our technical guides if you need a refresher on these concepts. All right, let's start with a quick recap of what we already discussed in the first episode. The optimization score is an estimate of how well things are set to perform. It is real-time and based on historical data and account context. When the score is not at its highest, then there is room for improvement on the account. Typically, this score can be used to check the health of accounts and prioritize daily management operations. So, how do we retrieve this score using the Google Ads API? I have prepared a few code examples to demonstrate the most common scenarios. Please note that I use the client library for PHP here, but the logic is exactly the same for all client libraries. Scores are retrieved like most other types of information, using the search stream or search methods of the Google Ads service. This type of execution can be split into four steps: authentication, construction of the GACL query, sending a call to the API, and extraction and use of the data from the API response. We only focus on the steps number 2 and 4 here. Scores are exposed at two levels, campaign and customer. For now, let's assume that we want to retrieve the scores at the campaign level. To do so, we need to use the campaign resource type in the from clause of the query. Then we can select any eligible fields for this resource type. Here we select the ID and the name, which are printed in the final step. To retrieve and print the scores, we need to add the optimization score field in the select clause. Later, we extract it from the results like any other field. The scores in the results are the same as in the Google Ads UI. The only difference is that they range from 0 to 1 instead of 0 to 100. In this particular case, we have three different campaigns in the account. The first two have scores of 50 and 80%. However, the last one has a score of 0%. The reasons for this is that the field is unset, which means that it is unscored. I just created this campaign, so it is likely due to a lack of historical data. Alright, now, what about the score for an entire account? We can find out by requesting the customer resource type. As you can see in this second code example, the overall logic is pretty similar. The main difference is that we need to search for customers instead of campaigns. In the select clause, we switch to customer-specific fields, including the optimization score. In the from clause, we switch to the customer resource type. And in the last step, we extract and print the new fields. To make it clear, if the score is unset, we print unscored this time instead of zero. Let's execute this example for a serving customer. This time, we only get the serving customer in the results with a score of 50%. Like campaigns, customers can also be unscored. In the case of this particular customer, this is because they do not yet have any campaigns. This is the case for all manager accounts as well, like this one. To find the score of a manager account, we need to rely on the optimization score weight, which is another field that is specific to the customer resource type. The higher the impact of a customer, the higher its weight. We can easily change the code example so that this additional field is selected and its result is printed. If I execute the example again for the first serving customer, we get the same result as before and a weight of 10. If a customer isn't scored, its weight is unset as well. For example, I can execute it again for the unscored serving customer and from the manager account. So how can the weight help us find the score of a manager account? Let's assume that a manager account manages 3 serving customers and that the scores and weights found using search requests are as follows. What we need to do is to sum the weighted score of each serving customer and divide by the sum of their weights. For this particular manager account, we get a score of 60%. With this formula, any customer that is unweighted has no impact on the score of the manager account. I implemented this exact logic in another code example for you. we identify all the serving customers of the manager account. We collect the scores and weights of all the serving customers by reusing the same logic as before. Then we use the formula to compute the score of the manager account. If I execute the example for this manager account with the three serving customers, we see that API requests are made to identify the serving customers and find their scores and weights. This leads to a score of 60% as expected. If we want to compute the score of a manager account with a greater depth, we still need to use the serving customer, but recursively this time. I already used the recursion in the code example to retrieve the manager account hierarchy. So if I execute it for a manager account with some manager accounts, we can see that the retrieved hierarchy now has more than two levels. And the serving customers under each of the manager accounts are included in the formula. The result is a score of 80%. I am adding all the details here in case you need it. This logic works nicely with any group of customers regardless of how they are organized. If I execute the example for a set of serving customers, we can see that the retrieved hierarchy has multiple routes, but the score is still computed as expected. The result is the same score. I am adding all the details here in case you need it. This was a lot, so let's take a step back and let's summarize the key technical details. Optimization scores are provided in real time, so you need to retrieve them regularly and store them if you want to track history. There is no specific period when the scores or weights are updated, and they may change in the future to improve accuracy. An optimization score ranges from 0 to 1 in the Google Ads API, which correlates to the 0 to 100 scale in the Google Ads UI. Using Google Ads API reporting, the score can be retrieved at the campaign level with the field optimization score. And it follows the same pattern at the customer level. The score can be missing, which means that the entity is unscored. This is the case for manager accounts. To find the score of a manager account, you need to compute it based on the scores and weights of all the customers that are linked to that manager account. The same logic applies with any group of customers, regardless of how they are organized. The best strategy is to recursively find all the serving customers before using the formula with their scores and weights. But make sure to only count each customer once. This is important because organizations can be complex and it is possible for multiple manager accounts to be linked to the same customers multiple times. To retrieve the weight of a customer, you need to add the field optimization score weight in the select clause of your query. If you have a large number of customers, be aware of the API rate limits and execution time. You need one API request per customer to get its score and weight, which can rapidly add up. Also, like the score, the weight can be missing. This happens for entities that are unweighted, such as manager accounts. And that's all I had for you today. If you're interested in this type of integration, you can check other dedicated resources listed here and check out the other episodes of this series. Thank you for watching. I will see you in other videos.